approche d'une riposte collective.
Microphone to ask two questions to two of our leaders here. We've heard.
L'agenda 2063, l'Afrique.
Faites des violences et des misères.
Pour remercier le président.
To President Muhammadu Yusufu of the Republic of.
Sur le plan économique.
My answer is Africa should embark on the provision of transport connectivity by enhancing the development of road, rail and air links, which will ease the free movement of persons, goods and services within the continent. In this regard, we in Nigeria have already commenced an aggressive drive to upgrade our rail transport system and road networks across the country. We are also pursuing the diversification of our economy through the development of agriculture and mineral resources, the promotion of manufacturing sector, and the creation of job opportunities for our teeming youth. By so doing, we will also discourage the irregular migration of our youth out of the continent through dangerous journeys. We should furthermore promote free trade within and amongst Africa and Africans, especially now that we have launched the Free Trade Area Agreement. Africa needs to intensify the fight against corruption. The menace of corruption undermines our efforts to achieve sustainable development and realize the goals of AU Agenda 2063. It is also important to attach great priority to the promotion of good and inclusive governance, as well as equally strive to empower our women and youth. As Africans, it is important to focus on the issue of conflict prevention and resolution. Conflicts have devastating effects on our societies, and they militate against our progress. In this regard, the need to silence the guns cannot be overemphasized. The issue of climate change should be given the due attention that it deserves. The effect of climate change, we are at the root, is at the root of some of the conflicts in parts of the continent. This is why we must focus on the issue of the recharging of Lake Chad, which used to provide livelihood to over 40 million people in the region. It is difficult to expect durable stability in the region without the restoration of the shrinking lake. My second question, ongoing reform efforts of the African Union presents a once-in-generational opportunity for strategic reflection and organizational renewal. We are the key reforms that will bring the organization closer to realizing its pan-African vision of an integrated, prosperous, peaceful African driven by its own citizens and representing a dynamic force in the global arena. The answer, in our efforts to accelerate African integration, we in Nigeria have already taken the strategic decision to bring down barriers that have hindered the free movement of our people within the continent by introducing the issuance of visa as the point of entry into Nigeria to all persons holding passports of African countries with effect from January 2020. Nigeria is of a strong opinion that Africa must take its destiny into its own hands by minimizing reliance on donor funding for the execution of its vital peace, security, and development agenda. In this regard, Nigeria has been funded by almost 100% the operation of the multinational joint task force fighting Boko Haram terrorists in the Lake Chad Basin. Nigeria is not only host to our sub-regional body ECOWAS, but has also been supporting substantially the ECOWAS budget up to about 60%. As a key tool for the transformation and repositioning of our continent, Africa would need to heavily invest in education and the capacity building. Education creates opportunities and holds the key for a better and prosperous future. I thank you very much.
Congratulations, welcome to the